So I'm here for this episode of The Vote with Craig Arden, and you're the regional officer from the National Education Union.
Yeah, that's right.
And just let's start off. We're going to be talking about Moulsecoomb Primary School, which is there's proposed to turn it into an academy.
Mm-hmm.
But before we do that, we'll just quickly chat about the NEU.
So, yeah, so what's it do? Who's just it very briefly, we are a relatively new trade union. We were formerly the NUT, National Union of Teachers, and the ATL, Association of Teachers and Lecturers. We merged, they no longer exist, and we are now the National Education Union, which is the biggest education union in Europe. I think it's the fourth biggest trade union in the UK. And we represent anybody who works in education, teachers, support staff, in all sectors and all phases.
Yeah, okay. And so it used to be NUT?
NUT was half of it, yeah.
NUT was half of it.
And the other half was the ATL.
How many people do you represent?
450,000 members.
That's a lot. So that's the union. And so you represent some of the teachers that are at Moulsecoomb Primary School.
Yeah, so I work as a regional officer in the South East region. Brighton is one of my areas. We've got an issue in Moulsecoomb Primary School, and so I'm leading on that campaign with a number of other people.
Perfect. So let's go on to the topic at hand then. So it's Moulsecoomb Primary School. It's there was an academy order, which I think was last year.
April this year. Yeah.
Under previous Secretary of State, I might add.
Yeah, that's right.
That there's an academy order, which means that basically it'll be taken out of council control. So
that's right.
Maybe just give us a bit of background around that issue.
Yeah, so the Academies Act 2010, which was brought in by the Conservative and Liberal Democrat coalition, that act says that if a school is deemed to be failing, which in this case, inadequate Ofsted rating, that's deemed failing, which is what the school got in April.
Yeah.
They're given an academy order, and that means that that school has no choice but to become part of a multi-academy trust. And somebody called the Regional Schools Commissioner, who is an unelected person, who they're tasked with finding an academy trust to become the sponsor of the school. So that's the situation the school's in at the moment.
Yeah, and this came off the back of the fact that there was an Ofsted report, wasn't there, which said that parts of the teaching there and the way that they kind of educate children was inadequate.
That's right. So the Ofsted report, the main issue with the Ofsted report was that it criticised outcomes for children at Key Stage 1 and Key Stage 2, but it also criticised some areas that are relatively outside of the control of the school, such as persistent absence. It also criticised the assessment of governors and leaders in terms of where they felt the school was at the time.
Yeah. And I should add that, that Moulsecoomb, Bevendine, that whole area, there's a lot of social deprivation there. So outcomes is an important factor in any kind of educational facility there because...
So what Ofsted doesn't do, and they have explicitly said that they won't do this, is that they won't take into account some of the context that's relevant to the school. They just look at what happens in the school. So Moulsecoomb, the pupil intake at Moulsecoomb has got a very particular demographic, which is very different from other schools in the city and also across the country. So, for example, a quarter of the school, the pupils in at Moulsecoomb, according to the most recently available data, require special educational needs support. That's double the national average. 47% of the pupils are eligible for free school meals. That's triple the national average. 12.5% of the pupils have English as an additional language. These create difficulties or challenges for the school, which means it's not fair to compare it to national averages in terms of progress and outcomes.
Yeah, and so there were some areas where they had improved, wasn't there?
Since Ofsted came in April, outcomes have actually significantly improved. So the latest round of SATS results from summer term show that there has been improvements in phonics in Key Stage 1 and significant improvements, which is one of the crucial areas, in Key Stage 2. Yeah. So that demonstrates that actually the leaders and the governors weren't inaccurate in their assessments because they did have a good understanding of where the school was and the trajectory of improvement that was it was already on. It just didn't have any data to demonstrate that at the time of the inspection.
Yeah, OK. So they had this Ofsted report, and then was it a surprise when an academy order came through? Because does an inadequate Ofsted report automatically lead to an academy order?
Yeah, so it was no surprise. We knew that was going to happen.
Yeah.
That's what the law says. That's the ideological position of the government, that privatising schools somehow leads to improvements when the evidence actually shows the opposite. It doesn't.
Yeah, OK. And so where are we at the moment with this, then? There's a whole... kind of a lot of factors around it. There's the community, there's the Brighton Hove City Council, obviously there's the teachers, the pupils themselves as well.
So a lot's happened since April.
Yeah.
There is strong opposition amongst the parents and the wider community. The council is opposed. staff of all three trade, well, all four trade unions that are represented in the school are also opposed. The ones that are representing classroom teachers and support staff, which are us, National Education Union, Unison and GMB, are all currently balloting staff for strike action. And our ballot, the NEU's ballot, will be closing next week, and we're very confident that will have a high return rate and a high yes vote. We had a petition, which the last time I checked had 2,600 signatures on it. We had a public meeting held in the school shortly after the Ofsted result was announced, which about 100 people came along to. That was the launch of the campaign, if you like. In June, there was a march and a rally through town. Over 300 people came along to that. We know that at least two academy trusts who were considering taking over the school have walked away. One was University of Brighton Academies Trust. Another one was called Step Academy Trust. And now the current situation is that a sponsor has been chosen and they have agreed to take over the school. And that is called New Horizons Academy Trust. And they're based in West Sussex. And the plan is for the school to convert by February.